So hello guys, today we'll be checking out interesting facts about Ajanta and Ellora caves. So first I'm going to start with Ajanta caves, which are approximately 30 rock cut Buddhist cave mountains which date from 2nd century BCE to 480 CE in Aurangabad district in Maharashtra of India. The cave includes painting and rock cut sculptures described as among the finest surviving examples of ancient Indian art. Particularly expressive paintings that present emotion through gesture, pose and form. According to the UNESCO, these are masterpieces of Buddhist religion art and influenced the Indian art that followed. The caves were built in two phases. The first phase starting around the 2nd century BCE, while the second phase was built around 400 to 650 CE. According to older accounts, on a brief period of 460 to 480 CE, according to later scholarship, the site is protected from a protected monument in the care of Archaeological Survey of India since 1983. The Ajanta Caves have been UNESCO World Heritage Site. The Ajanta Caves constitute ancient monasteries and worship halls of different Buddhist traditions carved into a 75-meter wall of rock. The cave also presents paintings depicting the past lives and births of Buddha. The Ajanta Caves are mentioned in the memoirs of several medieval-era Chinese Buddhist travelers to India and by a Mughal-era official of Akbar in the early 17th century. They were covered by jungle until accidentally discovered and brought to the Western attention in 1819 by a colonial British officer, Captain John Smith, on a tiger hunting party. The caves are on the northern wall of the U-shaped gorge of river Vakur in the Deccan Plateau. Within the gorge are a number of waterfalls audible from outside the caves when the river is high. Next we'll be checking out about Ellora Caves. It is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site located in Aurangabad district of Maharashtra. It is one of the largest rock cut monastery temples in the world, featuring Buddhist, Hindu and Jain monuments artwork dating from 600 to 1000 CE period. Cave 16 in particular features a large single monolithic rock excavation in the world from Kailasha temple, a chariot shaped monument dedicated to Shiva. The Kailasha temple excavation also features sculptures depicting gods and goddesses mythologies found in Vaishnavism, Shaktism, also well-relief panels summarizing the two major Hindu epics. There are over 100 caves at the site, all evacuated from the basalt cliffs in Chandrani Hills 34, which are open to public. Although these caves are served as monasteries, temples and rest of for pilgrims, the site's location on ancient South India trade route also made it an important commercial center in the Deccan region. It is 29 kilometers 18 miles northwest of Aurangabad and about 300 kilometers, which is 190 miles east northeast of Mumbai. Today, the Ellora Caves, along with near Ajanta Caves, are a major tourist attraction in Marathwada region of Maharashtra. A protected monument and under the Archaeological Survey of India. So, thank you guys for watching. Make sure to smash the like button and subscribe for more content.